Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm so glad that I can join you in your respective rooms, wherever you might be, or maybe in your own cars. You know, it's my privilege just to be able to share more of God's word to you today in the very brief moments that we have together. You know, first and foremost, before I jump into what's in my heart to share, I just really want to give a hearty appreciation to all of our life group leaders out there. Thank you for doing what you do. Thank you for not just sharing the word in season to our people, but aside from that, thank you for loving on them and really taking care of the people whom God truly loves. You know, you guys are appreciated. A lot of the things that you do behind the scenes, probably nobody notices, but Jesus does, and that's sufficient. So once again, saranghaeyo. So again, I want to share to you something straight from my heart. I believe that that's from God. And I want to quote this verse very quickly, and from there we're going to go on. In Psalms 1, verse 1 to 3, it says, "Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night." First thing I want to tell you today is the word delight. We're going to be talking about three things, the first thing of which is delight. Delight in what? The Bible says to delight the Word of God. You know, when you talk about delight, it has more to do beyond the action. It has more to do with the sincerity of the heart. You can be doing one thing, but not necessarily delighting in it. You know, when I bring my wife to certain places, it is my delight to see a response, to see how, you know, it would affect her, how the joy of making her like look like a little girl once again because of my surprises. I take delight in that. You know, I delight when I'm able to bring her places, the things that we just simply talk about, and then I can make certain dreams, ika nga, come to pass. That's a delight. It's not just something that I do. My entirety of my heart is in it. I delight in it. In the same way, God wants you to know that the best way to really approach the Word of God, to receive from the Word of God, is to delight in it. You know, that word delight carries with it a connotation that says that you have to be very purposeful. You have to pour your heart into it. And the best way for us to really delight in the Word of God is to have an understanding that the Word is God's ultimate love letter to us. Yes, it's full of instructions. Yes, it's full of commands. It's full of revelation. It's full of admonitions, even for our daily life. But in spite of that, the very foundation of all of that is because God is love. He loves you. I remember writing love letters in seasons past. Ngayon siguro baka, maybe it's no longer the norm. Maybe it's more of emails and PMs. I'm more of an old school baby. I love old school. And for me, love letters, man, we would write that with our own hands. And you would know the sincerity, the intentionality of writing a love letter is because kahit na mahaba, even if it's long, every word is laced with meaning. Do you know that the Word of God is full of His love? Every book, every chapter, every verse is laced with the love of God. So I encourage you, delight in it. You know why? Because He delights in you. That's the first thing I want to share to you today. Delight in His Word. The second thing is draw. And that's what the Bible says in our verse earlier. It says, "He who is planted like a tree by rivers of living water." A tree that is planted by the river inevitably and effortlessly draws from the river. The roots go down deep. The deeper it goes, the more nutrients it gets. You know, the more that you delight in the Word of God, drawing from the Word of God is just an effortless continuation of you just simply delighting in it. The Bible says in Luke 10, talking about Mary and Martha, Jesus said, "Mary has chosen the good part, which will not be taken away from her." And what does the Bible say Mary was doing at that time? She was just simply at the feet of Jesus, hearing His word. She was in total delight. That was her heart. And what was she doing? she was drawing from Jesus. You see, when you draw from Jesus, when you receive from Him, when you receive the Word, you know, for all of you life group leaders, you know when somebody is receiving from you, di ba? When you are sharing the Word, when you share life, when you share life's experiences in your life group settings, there are some who are probably distracted, you know, looking around. If you used to do it in the mall and, you know, something passes by, their attention is automatically drawn there. You know, at that particular time, they are not drawing from you, right? Wala akong pinatatamaan. If anybody gets hit by that, I do encourage you to tune in to your life group leaders all the more. But as a life group leader, you know when people are drawing from you. You know why? Because they're delighting in the time that they have with you as well. So when you draw, God wants you to know that you can draw because His supply is limitless. It is endless. You can never out-receive what God has freely given and what God continually gives. He is overflowing. An endless supply is what our Jesus carries. That's why you can draw from Him today. Draw from His Word. The Bible says that it is the glory of man to seek out the mysteries that are veiled in the Word. And when you know what is God's good pleasure, to reveal them to you. So keep drawing. When you draw, it adds to you. When you receive, it adds to you. We always have this question, what is the most important responsibility of a mother cow? Some of you might say it's to feed the young. Some of you it might say it's to feed the newborn. No, it's not. It is to draw and feed for herself. Why? Because without drawing for herself, she has nothing to give out to her young. So the importance of drawing. So you delight, you draw, and lastly, what I want to share to you, the last D is defy. D-E-F-Y, defy. The Bible says, again in our verse, it says, "He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither." When you are drawing the way that God wants you to, when you are delighting in His Word, it creates a supernatural resilience in your heart because you are so full of Jesus. You are so full of truth. You are so full of truth that you do not fall for any lies. Real talk right now. In the days that we live in, there's a lot of lies. We have made influencers, YouTubers, we have made social media, any artist who's out there, any person who has a camera and a microphone and put it on social media, we have made them to be epitomes of truth. We have, in some cases, in some senses, we have allowed our lives to revolve around what these experts supposedly say. But we are not called to build our lives on their lives. We are called to build our lives on the Word. And when there's so much of truth in you, the Bible says, you get to outlast the seasons. What does that mean? That means that the seasons, the suddenlies in life, have less of an effect on you. Why? Because you are standing on truth. You are standing on the strength of God. Where do you find that? In the Word. In His Word. That's why God wants you to delight, to draw from Him, so you can defy life's suddenlies and life's different seasons. I don't know what you guys may be in right now in your life groups. I don't know what challenges you may be facing. But one thing is for sure, the Word of God is always timely and it is timeless. So I hope that this blessed you. And I hope that this would add, not just for this particular moment that you're watching this, but I hope that this would bless your days all throughout. It would bless your life groups and the families of your life group members. Well, God bless you, family. Once again, Pastor Mon here, and it's my delight to bring this word to you.